I have hair loss even after using Minoxidil 5% and Deutomix tablets for 7 months. Could I get a hair transplant? Hi, I'm seeing hair fall even though I'm using medicines to stop and regrow hair. I decided to have a hair transplant. Can I go for it? My age is 25. I feel depressed every day, so I want to go for a hair transplant. Please suggest.
Thank you for your question. You're 25 years old, and you describe in your question that you've been using minoxidil and a medication called Deutomix, and you're still losing hair. And you submitted a photo that is clearly demonstrating significant hair loss. And you're asking about a transplant. So before we answer this question, and I think that I'm actually going to have something that you can benefit from that is different than what is traditionally offered in for hair loss. And I think you'll appreciate what I'll discuss. But first, let's first discuss the issues that you have and what the current standard of care treatments are. First of all, most likely what you have is called male pattern hair loss or male pattern baldness. And it's a genetic trait, runs in families, variable expression. So it's not a direct dominant or recessive trait. It is something that tends to show up. And even between siblings, one can have lots of hair, one can have a tremendous amount of hair loss. So in the United States, the drugs that are approved for male pattern hair loss are finasteride and minoxidil. Finasteride is a tablet that is used, taken daily, 1 milligram, that is used to inhibit an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. 5-alpha reductase inhibits or blocks the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone will affect susceptible hair follicles, which will then thin and then eventually disappear. Minoxidil is a topical treatment available over the counter. Minoxidil does not stop the progression of hair loss. Finasteride can slow down the progression because it's working systemically from the inside in a very specific way. Unfortunately, a significant percentage of men do not respond to finasteride, and at this time, many people who are in their 20s and 30s are concerned about reports of long-term sexual side effects, and in our practice are just coming in refusing to take it at all. Then the alternative traditionally has been to do a hair transplant. Now, a hair transplant is a surgical relocation of hairs that are resistant to loss, which are located in the back of the scalp in an area we call the donor area. This is a genetically resistant hair. This means that hair from this area will never fall out. No matter how long you live, the hair will remain in place. So you can take those hairs and place them in the front. Now, unfortunately, the donor area is limited. And because it's limited, there's only so many hairs you can move. Now, with hair transplantation, it appears that culturally or in general, the limitations of hair transplant, where you can mostly fill the frontal hairline and define it, it's more acceptable for men who are in their 30s, 40s, and 50s because at that point, a lot of men have significant hair loss. In our experience, 20 years in practice, men in their 20s expect to have a lot more volume because by the rule of decades, which is a rule of thumb that we use in hair restoration, men in their 20s, only 20% will have hair loss, while 80% will have tremendous hair. So even with a transplant, you won't get the volume that you desire, and you will have only a limited amount of hair. In addition, nothing is stopping the progression of hair loss. Therefore, you will continue to lose hair, and eventually your transplant area or donor area will be tapped out. We have had tremendous success with a method of restoring thinning hair that we call hair regeneration. This concept is something we've developed over several years and has been very successful in treating male and female pattern hair loss using a material called extracellular matrix. In our practice, we have developed a process, a protocol, and a method that is combined. It's a combined platelet-rich plasma, extracellular matrix. Platelet-rich plasma, by the way, is your own blood spun down to concentrate the platelets and the growth factors and taking out the red blood cells. This combination has been very successful in helping people, what we believe, through a wound healing mechanism. This material, extracellular matrix, is derived from pig bladder, and it is used traditionally for wound healing, and it happened to be a remarkable serendipitous observation that when used for the benefit of a hair transplant incision, the area of hair that was not transplanted, which was thinning, actually got thicker. So this hair regeneration treatment at this point has, with over 3 to 5 years of significant data, and particularly in the past 3 years, we have had limited need to do any reinjection. We have close to 100% success rate for male pattern hair loss. So I think that that an option for you is to learn about hair regeneration and this extracellular matrix and research and find a provider that you'd be comfortable with in terms of treatment. As far as the concept of a transplant, I'm not writing off the potential for a transplant, but in our practice, we have shifted our philosophy, and I'm a cosmetic surgeon, board certified, and able to do everything from head to toe. In fact, what we have been helping a lot of our patients do is not have a hair transplant, but rather do the injection, see how much volume of hair is restored through this method, and if they still want a transplant, we can be much more strategic. Remember, we're dealing with a limited donor area. So by strategically restoring hair, which is limited in terms of the coverage, but we can actually get what I feel is a significant amount of coverage by doing a non-surgical treatment, by doing this injection. So I know this is different from the information that you probably have, but I think that when you learn more about this, we have patients who come from all over the world, and unfortunately hair loss is an area where a lot of predatory behaviors occur, where people are offering supplements and miracle treatments and all kinds of gimmicks and gadgets which don't work. But hair regeneration is something that we have tremendous data about, and I think that you will benefit from learning about it. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.